biodigester construction secrets that you need to know if you are a biodigester constructor. The first biodigester construction secret that you need to know is to be an apprentice if you want to be a good constructor in the future. For any kind of job that you want to enter into, you need an experience. And experience comes from being an apprentice. It means that you have to learn on the job to become a good constructor. I have seen people just take on jobs that they have no clue about. And then they just mess up the first important job that they do get. And then they are out of the market because nobody is going to give them referral for such a job that they have done. What it means is that you do not become the qualified installer that you want to be, and then you do not get prospective jobs or prospective clients in the future. Because if you do get somebody call you, say that they want to construct a biodigester, most of the time either they have seen your job. I know people go online, go on the internet, Facebook, and then they take pictures of some other people's job and they use it as their job. I have seen several people form companies, even form Facebook pages based on my company, Dreamhouse Biodigesters, and they are out there constructing biodigester, or they are out there looking for biodigester work, saying that this is the kind of jobs that they have done. You are going to be found out. For every kind of job or for every kind of thing in life, you need to be good at it. When I started this business, what I did was to work with a company and work with a group and understudy. Over 2 years understudy, understand all the permutation, all the implications for everybody that gets the construction that we had to do. And it was key to get the whole system right. Because the key thing is for biodigesters, you need to know that you need to have a good gradient. You need to know the location where you are going to locate the digester. You need to understand how technically the slopes or how many, the number of pipes that are coming from the house, how you are going to have them managed. And then whether you actually need to do two or one digester, you need to do a large one, you need to do a medium size, depending on the average users of the facility in the house. So these are some of the few key things that you need to know. The second biggest biodigester construction secret that you need to know is to take on jobs that you can execute. Just simply take on projects that you know you can execute to the best of your ability. Do not go and take on a project. Somebody is building a hospital and you are a newly biodigester constructor, and then you go and send a proposal and they give you the job. And that job is definitely going to be a failure, because you do not have the rudiments of biodigester construction. And you need to understand that it's best as a constructor, what I always advise is, do one for yourself at your backyard, or do one for your grandmother in the village, for your parents outside the city, or for any property that is not really a big property where you are going to mess yourself up. So take on simple projects, simple low-income houses in the area. I'm not going to charge you for anything. Just give me the materials and then I'll get the job done for you. And then you can build your confidence, you can build your project line, you can build your understanding based on that simple job. And you can also use it for referral. You can go back to it. If it's a so-called pit that you did, you can see how it's working. You can see the groundwork and then you can see whether your slope and everything is working. You can actually go anytime and open it up and see how the biodegradation itself is working for you. Then you can use that, do all your workings, and then write down some notes and things. And based on that, in fact, use different materials. If you can get two or three different projects, try different decomposition materials and see which one will actually work best for you. The third biggest biodigester construction secrets that you need to know is to consult other biodigester constructors. If you do have a job and you are not sure of what is it that you are doing, ask questions. Come on my YouTube channel and leave a message. To the best of my ability, I try to reply to most of the messages that I do get. So come on the page and ask questions. Send us a WhatsApp, send us an email and ask questions. And then to the best of our ability, we can also try and help you to understand some of the things that you need to know. You have to collaborate. I do get jobs and I'm on the phone to some of the experienced constructors that I know in the system, and I ask them questions. Sometimes I have to go and take them to the site to have a second opinion, to have a different understanding of what is it that you are doing. Sometimes you go on an inspection to a site, and the first instinct is to, oh, let's build the digester here. Oh, you haven't seen Hanum, and I have a digester this year. And then you just make the decision. But when you do get a second opinion or a technical advice, you'll be told that, look, even though your first estimation is okay, I think it should be here, I think it should be here, it makes sense here, and then it will make sense here, and the gradient will come from here, or the slope is coming from here, so let's put it here. Let's not send it to the back of the building because the slope is coming to the front of the house, and then it means that all the water will be coming here, when all the rainwater will show up at a particular point. And you need to know all these things when you want to construct a biodigester. So consult other qualified instructors or constructors or biodigesters and seek their second opinion if you want to become a good biodigester constructor. The fourth most important biodigester construction secret that as a biodigester constructor you need to know is to ask the homeowner the right questions. The number of toilet seats that you have in the house, where the project is located, what kind of soil do you have in your estimation is there. Most of them will ask you to come to the house and do inspection, but it's good to have a background knowledge of what exactly you are going to meet when you show up on somebody's project or somebody's site, so to understand what is it that you're coming to look at. So it's good to ask the right question before you come to a conclusion whether this is a digester or this is a project that you can take on. And then the moment you ask the right question, you are clear in your mind where you are going to be and what exactly that you are going to do. So it's key for biodigester construction to ask the owners of the property the right questions and get the right understanding before you take on a job. In fact, some of the homeowners will prefer you putting the digester at a particular location. And if that's what meets the requirement and is okay for you, go ahead. Don't go and be suggesting things that people are not pleased with. The customer always comes first, and they need to be happy before you are locating their biodigester. The video showing happiness will explain to you exactly what I'm talking about when I mean how biodigesters work in this part of the world.